sense of getting a GR.
Thank you.
in just 5 minutes for an exciting out-of-this-world tour through our solar system. Once again, please join us in just 5 minutes at our planetary research station for an outer-stellar tour of our solar system. Planetary research. But I will be your host today on a tour through our solar system. And I will say my first officer did ask me to wish you a long life. Okay, so anyway. So we're going to actually take a tour through our solar system. Anyone know why we call it a solar system? What do you think?
A planet.
Well, it has planets in our solar system. Well, we call it the solar system probably before Copernicus. He's the one that finally assured everyone that we were not the center of our system, that the sun was the center of our system. So everything in our solar system revolves around the sun. Sol is from the Latin for sun, and so that's why we call it the solar system. Anyway, so what everything orbits around the sun. Another thing about the sun is, of all the mass that exists in our solar system, that means all the planets, all the moons, all the comets, the asteroids, everything that exists in our solar system, 98% of it is right there in that sun. Only 2% exists outside of that, and most of that is in Jupiter, believe it or not. So 98% of it is in there. That is a lot. And it's a good thing. Because of that mass in the sun, that's what keeps us in here orbiting around the sun. Without that mass, as we go orbiting around it, we would just drift off into space. And that would not be a good thing. Because without being captured by the sun, we would soon find ourselves in a very cold, frozen planet. No life, no liquid water, none of that. We would actually die. The other thing is that we get our heat from the sun. And that happens through a process deep inside the core of that sun. It's called nuclear fusion. What is happening, there's so much mass in the sun that the pressures at the core are so intense that it fuses the hydrogen and helium. That's nuclear fusion. And it's doing it at the rate, this is hard to believe, I read this a few months back now, it's consuming the hydrogen on the sun at the rate of 700 million tons every second, which is converting that 700 million tons to 695 million tons to helium and another 500 gamma rays. So that sounds pretty ominous, doesn't it? But despite that, it's been doing it forever, and scientists say we've got another 5.5 billion years left in the sun, so we have no concern about running out of it. That's what's going on there. The pressure is so great, it's causing that nuclear fusion. At the core of the sun, it is very, very hot, over 27 million degrees Fahrenheit. That's pretty hot. On the surface, it's 10,000 degrees Fahrenheit. A lot cooler up there. Yeah, just quite hot. Now you probably notice some of these. Well, this one doesn't show very many dark spots, but the darker spots on there, if we were able to blank out all the rest of the sun, those dark spots would be 7,000 degrees Fahrenheit. They would be brighter than our moon. And notice these yellow areas here, bright yellows. Sometimes I think here's one that's flaring out over here. They call those our solar flares. And this, yes.
Over here, off the sun right here, that's pretty bad white because it's like showing.
No, that's just because they probably haven't aligned or coordinated all the cameras together. This is an interesting facility here. It's computerized done. There are four different images of the sun, and they're projected onto this orb right here. And apparently, they haven't quite lined it up with this image yet, so you've got a gap which keeps trying to fill itself together there. So, okay. So the solar flares, they are the ones that actually have a great impact upon how hot or cold it is here on Earth. Back in 1650 to 1700, there was hardly any solar flare activity, and they started to call that period a mini ice age. It got so cold here on Earth. But it goes through a cycle. The sun has an 11-year cycle. We're at year 9 right now. So we have, let's see, we're on year 7 right now. So we have 4 more years of the sun's increased activity. And the ship gets hotter for the next 4 more years, and then it'll finally cool down again, and it'll start over. Anyway, so there's our sun, that's the center of our system. And from there we go, I'm going to show you a picture, or an image of the sun in the background, and the planets in our solar system up against the sun. We do that because all of our images, all the planets are going to be displayed on this sphere. I don't want any of you to think that all the planets are the same size. They're not. Here is the sun, and as you can see over here, we got Jupiter and Saturn, Uranus and Neptune out here. Over here we've got Mars, Earth, and Venus, and Mercury. Notice Earth and Venus are the only ones that are fairly close together in size. They're about Venus about 90% the size of the Earth, and it's very similar to us. So here's all of our planets, and there is the sun in comparison. Now here, here is Earth right there. See that little spot? I'll show you close as well. So this one is.
Thank you. Watch the screen to see if you chose correctly.
No, it's right here. Supposed to be right here.
Drop the correct ones.
Thank you.
exist.
Times 10,000 times water, 1,000 times more dense than water, 100 times more dense than water. That's water. Now let's turn it upside down, see what happens. Water one go first, that's 100 times water. That is 1,000 times water. That is 10,000 times water. It's not even moving. Actually, it's moving really slow. Let's see. This is moving. It's still moving. Yeah, it's still moving. Pretty slow.
Thank you. motion, and the driver experiences more gravitational force than the astronauts on the space shuttle launch.
That one's hard. Turn, Lily, turn. You got it.
These are not real. It's fake. Can't remove it either. Tomato. Can't remove it. Good one.
Yeah.
Back. Go back. Yeah.